Citizen Television.
Greetings and welcome to another episode of The Planetary Persuader. My name is Cosmic Kev. I am your host and I will lead you through the stars, through the luminaries, through the 12 signs of the zodiac and their 12 houses. And the forecast is for May 3rd through the 9th, 10th of 2013. So this is a pretty cosmic week, folks, because we've got a new moon solar eclipse in Taurus on May 9th. Now here in the left coast of North America, we've got it at 5:28 p.m. So 5:28, we're going to have that solar eclipse, you know, and so it's before sunset over here, probably closer to sunset if you're in the Central Standard Time region, but or central daylight at this point, I should say. So anyhow, what do we know about Taurus? You know, Taurus is second sign of the zodiac, and its key phrase is I have. So we associate it with a relationship with the earth. It's an earth sign. It's fixed earth. So the fixed signs generally personify the energy of the season. So Taurus is mid-spring, you know, they're kind of like the ruler of the spring energy, which is green grass growing. It's a time when cows let down more milk. Same thing with goats too. There's, you know, there's usually a little more abundance. We've had a little bit of time for things to warm up during the Aries period, and now real growth is taking place. It's also a sign that symbolizes stability to some extent, and for sure it does also symbolize stubbornness, stick-neckedness, so conservative that maybe is stuck in a rut and won't change even if it's life-threatening, you know, so that's probably the downfall of Taurus. But on the upside, it's tolerant and it's sensual, and it loves physical play and good food and being out in nature, working in a garden. All these wonderful things. Still have Jupiter in Gemini, Saturn retrograde in Scorpio. So Saturn's sort of in the balance of this. You know, Saturn's keeping watch and saying, okay, you know, you can have your simple pleasures, but remember that, you know, everything is transitory. Death is a part of the scene. And with desire often comes attachment. So can we be transcendent in our lovemaking and our attitudes towards it? You know, so there's that question too. And good times. I mean, this is going to be the strongest of all the eclipses. We have another lunar eclipse coming 2 weeks later on the 24th, but this is really the big one. Okay, so kick back, enjoy yourself as we go sign by sign on this week's version of The Planetary Persuader.